Okay, YouTube. I am going to show you that anybody can paint. All you got to do is apply yourself. So, I'm also going to show you that you only need three colors. And white. One. Here, I'll move this over so you can see it. Blue. I normally use the phthalo blue or phthalo blue, whatever you call it. Here, where's my glasses so I can actually see what I'm doing? Brilliant red or scarlet red. Let's try scarlet red. I think I like that better. That looks pretty red. And if you want to darken it up, make it blood red, it's not that hard. And here's yellow. This is just medium yellow. According to these colors. Looks like a cadmium yellow to me. So if you look, some of you might not be able to tell, but these are two different color yellows. So what's on the outside of the paint is not the same as on the inside of the paint. We're not going to use that white. We're going to use this white. We're using acrylics because anybody can use acrylics. And I want a lot of white. So got some water here for a wash if I decide I want to do that. These are the three colors that I use, and that's all you need to make any color on the palette. As strangely as that might sound to some of you. So, I took some pictures tonight, so I'm going to use those as points of reference. But you don't need to see them, you just need to see the finished product. And we're going to start with the sky. The sky is always the best thing to start with because then you're working up to down, and anything that you paint on top of it will be the way. You can always go back, though. Don't get me wrong. You can definitely go back. So, to start our sky, we're going to use a paintbrush. I like these. They're comfortable. Take a little bit of red, a little bit of blue, mix them up, put a little bit of white in there, gray it up, and then just a dab of yellow to gay it up. Not really, but this is going to make like a nice base color for this guy. And if you're like, the sky ain't brown, you don't know what I'm trying to paint. So wait until I'm done, because that seems like a lot of brown. But one little brush can make a world of difference. And also, like, what was his name? Art Ross. Art Ross used to say, we're going to throw some happy little clouds in there. And anything that I do, and like I say, it's a night sky, so I'm trying to make it interesting for everybody. And then, after you get your gray in there, you can add a little bit of blue. Bring it all together. It's actually fading out pretty intensely. This will, oh, it's okay to make messes, right? That's what they say.
Yeah, that's what Art Ross used to say.
You'll probably notice that I'm getting my countertop all painted, but it's okay because I know how to clean it off. And my wife isn't here to ruin it for me. So we're just going to go with it. Now, what I want to do is a New England style town. But I'm going to put a house right in the center here. And this house is a very specific house on my street. And the way that house looks, it's not like that. It's more like that, and then that, and then we'll just brush the sky back. So anyways, you can probably see shapes, but you can't really see much of anything else. And what I'm going for is a little bit of this, a little bit of this, and a little bit of that. So that's where I'm gonna bring it all around. I'm gonna do the hokey pokey and turn myself around because that's what it's all about. So here I see that my roof was all wrong. It's more like this, and it's more like this. And then it's a wee bit of this. So yeah, this is actually a portrait of somebody's house, and I probably didn't mention that. And what I'm trying to do make a quick Christmas present for someone because they gifted me a couple of fly fishing flies made from the fur of my dog. Which is an interesting story in itself. But the funny part is that their style house is actually the same style as my style of house. So yes, that's a distant neighbors become friends. He said my dog walked through his yard. I thought he was going to yell at me. And instead he said he picked up some of his hair and I made you these. And gave me fly fishing hooks, which I thought was kind of interesting. You know, if you're into fly fishing. So the There's a lot of weird angles. And the cool thing about a painting is nothing ever has to be perfect. And nobody's going to see the imperfections except for you. So, if you're crazy like me, but not in a neurotic way, because I'm not, you can make a few mistakes without anybody knowing that they're mistakes at all. You can keep your emotions in your pocket and not freak out about what's going on. And when you want to fix something, the universe has a way of fixing it for you. That's why I never stress about anything anymore, because the universe fixes it for you all the time. All you gotta do is wait. This is kind of a cute, I don't know if you can see it, cute little Christmassy house. Just enough lights to make it look like it's Christmas, but not enough lights. Make it gross. So, oh, did I tell you? This might be a long painting, but there's no time frame that you gotta, I think hopefully you can just enjoy the fact that you're watching and learning. And as you saw, I didn't draw anything out. I'm just going by intuition. And the cool thing is, if I end up not liking it, I don't have to give it to anybody. Or if I end up liking it too much, I can end up keeping it for myself. Especially seeing, this looks just like my house. Except for a couple of minor factors. But what's really crazy is, I used to have a sailboat. Like the one in this window that, maybe not exactly, but that I used to kind of cherish for a while. And it was something that I wanted to put in the same window. Then when I saw his, I thought, nah, too much work. So, I never did. But, as far as painting, painting is a gut feeling. Painting is what you feel like doing at the time. The other thing is, don't ever try to copy anybody else's work. Do your own thing. If you're trying to copy somebody else, chances are you'll never get it. But inspiration from somebody else's work is flattery. And also, sometimes improve. I didn't tell you that I like to do kind of an impressionistic thing. It makes it easy because every brush stroke is different and every brush stroke doesn't need to be perfect. And you can make subtle changes with a simple brush stroke. And fix problems along the way. I told this guy I was going to do this a while ago, so he probably forgot, or he probably thought I was full of shit when I told him I was going to paint him a picture of his house. But it is what it is. Obviously, this area here is bigger. Well, yeah, see, so now I've realized that my house is not wide enough. And I want to bring it out more, so not a hard fix, but it's never going to be as perfect as you think anyway. So this is actually a little bit bigger, and then this is actually a little bit wider. Anyways, anything that I do will look perfect anyways, because I'm not trying to impress anybody. I'm not saying that I'm perfect, but I'm just saying I'm not trying to impress anybody. This lawn goes like this. And it's all about just utilizing your So this line should be here. This line should be here. And then he's got another little line here. Those are inconsequential areas anyways. But a little bit of green. Well, a little bit of yellow. A little bit. So when I mix my colors, I don't really give a shit as far as how mixed they are or what the name of the color is. So, like, Art Ross used to sit there and say happy little trees and some burnt umber and some this, that, and the other thing. That's not the way I operate. As you can see, my paintbrush has streaks in the paint, and I think it gives it more flavor when you're making a painting. The more flavor you add, the better it ends up. Now, I see a lot of flaws with my painting, but I'm okay with it because I'm trying to bring it all together. Got a bush like on the side of his house, and then his roof comes down a little bit more and it comes over here. So sometimes it's a learning curve. But the important stuff is I'm not just trying to paint his house. And so I don't draw on the painting, because if I sit there and draw on the painting, there's going to be pencil under the paint. And by me not doing that, there's no erasing, there's no nothing. It's just clean fun. So let's work on the sky a little bit. We'll go back to that moon picture that I saw tonight. These are all pictures I took tonight that I'm using as my points of reference. So I don't know if you've seen the New England town style paintings, but that's what I'm going to go for in the long run. But for starters, what I'm going to do is I want to do the moon strikes here. The moon. Actually, when you do the moon, it doesn't have to be a perfect circle. But I can make it a little bit better than it was there. Right? Like that. That's pretty damn good. Use language. There. I like that. Because the moon's not really huge. It's actually way smaller than that. But what we're going to do is now we're going to make some clouds. So we're going to pull out some gray. And we're just going to tease the sky. And bring out some of the things that we like about the photograph. Imagine a few years ago when you had these ideas of what you wanted to paint, but you actually had to remember what they were or go out with your camera, take a bunch of photographs, and then wait a week for your film to be developed, and then go back and paint so that it would end up looking like what you took pictures of, and you had points of reference, or you could paint on site like the old masters used to do. And the cool thing is, watch this. To give it flavor, there's a number of ways you can do it. Got a blue in there because there is blue in there. And then take my wet brush and it's a process. It's not something that is just gonna fall into place all of a sudden. But as you start seeing it, you start realizing what it is you're making. So, like, some people might go, oh, it's starting to look like daytime. And you know what? It might end up being a daytime type picture, but I don't care. Because the ideas that I have are far beyond anything that you can imagine right now. And I'll show you what I mean in a minute. Because this guy's got a house here and a house here. And I don't care about those houses. So we're going to let the fog roll in. But we're also going to describe the town. And one of the things about the town is, that I like is way off in the distance, if you had fish eyes, you would see a railroad bridge. I don't even remember what the town bridges look like, but what I do know is what the river through town looks like. Shut up, Thunder. Go lay down. Oh, why are you bothering Max? Go lay down. I'll get your food in a little while.
What's up, go lay down?
Actually, makes me wanna. Sultan Bridge. There we go. So yeah, technically I got two bridges. I've got this arched bridge like this, and I actually pretty impressed that I remember the shape of it. And then, let's see. That's the freeway bridge. And then the train bridge. It's a little bit rustier on the back side. And the train bridge, it's a little bit more like this behind it, and I'm actually doing it backwards, but I'll be able to use that to my advantage, because both bridges are right there, and if I remember correctly, and there's a third bridge, the walking bridge. And there's the Indian standing in front of the bridge. Well, that's right, he used to stand closer to the center of town. So anyways, you got your bridges. What else do you have? You have your rusty little town over here. Then way off in the distance, we've got mountains. And the mountains kind of set a tone for the whole town. So, there I have the basis for my picture. But then I also want to put some houses in the background. So, to tell it that it's a town full of houses, what we're going to do is we're going to put some tiny houses randomly behind it.